Hello student, today I will discuss from geography second chapter physical features of India. You have seen last day I have discussed up to the Deccan Plateau the physiographic division of India most important part. This is the Deccan Plateau. Today I will start another important division of Indian physiography. This is the Indian desert. Indian desert. When you will heard the term desert, one thing you will recall or you will remind that one common thing you can found in the desert region. What is this? Obviously, this is sand. Why sand we can found in the desert region? You know why sand is a common in a desert region? The main reason is desert region always have the harsh climatic condition. That means extreme climatic condition, either extreme hot or extreme cold. Amount of rainfall is not sufficient. So due to that reason, instead of soil, that particular areas form sand. So desert can be two types, hot desert and cold desert. Generally hot desert you can found sand, in a cold desert you can found ice. Now India's most important, one of the important division, this is the Great Indian Desert, which is situated in the state of Rajasthan and some parts of Gujarat. That means the northwestern part of our country have the desert. The main state is Rajasthan and also some parts of Gujarat. We can found the desert. Now the Indian desert lies toward the western margin of Aravalli Hills. Aravalli Hills also one of the oldest mountain range all over the world. After Aravalli mountain range, Himalayan mountain range also was formed. So western part of Aravalli range, the western margin of Aravalli range, this is the Great Indian Desert, and it is an undulating sandy plains covered with sand dunes. Undulating means a wavy structure. This is called undulating topography. So undulating plain covered by sand and also have the sand dunes. What is sand dunes? A heap of sand which is found in the desert region. This is called sand dunes. Sand dunes are formed generally blowing up wind. And these sand dunes can shifted or move from one place to another place by the force of wind. So this type of features are very common in the desert region, undulating topography and sand dunes. Now obviously another important characteristic, this is this, the desert region received less than 150 millimeter rainfall. Less than 150 millimeter rainfall is received in the desert region. That's why this area become a desert. The amount of rainfall is very low per year. It has arid climate with low rainy season. Obviously it has arid climate, temperature also very high and amount of rainfall also very low. Arid means a dry climate. Here arid means a dry climate. So it is very important short question, in which part of our country we can found the arid climate or arid type of climate? Obviously it in desert. And also stream appear during the rainy season. Stream here, stream means river. River you can found only the rainy season. Little amount of rainfall also occurred. Due to that reason, water, river also get sufficient amount of water and stream also appear during that time. Soon after they disappear into the sand and they do not have enough water and reach the sea. So that's why in river in the desert region can't reach toward the sea because the insufficient of water. And Luni is the only large river in this region. Very important. Also in your book, when you read the drainage chapter, you will see in Rajasthan, there have a river, only one large river. This is Luni River. So these are the important features you have read in Great Indian Desert or Indian Desert. Barkhans, crescent-shaped dunes, sand dunes, when it become a crescent shape, it is called Barkhans, covered a large areas, but longitudinal dunes become more prominent near the Indo-Pakistan boundaries. If you will visit the Jaisalmer, you also found. So Barkhans is also a crescent-shaped dunes. Crescent-shaped dunes is called a Barkhan, and also longitudinal dunes, some dunes are also situated like that. Longitudinal dunes are also found in the Pakistan border. So these are the important characteristics of Great Indian Deserts. So I'll repeat again this one. So Great Indian Desert situated in the northwestern part of our country. It is also a western margin of Aravalli mountain range. In our country, Rajasthan is an important state which is also situated in that particular area, and some parts Gujarat also. This region have the undulating topography and also covered with sand dunes, and receive less than 150 millimeter water rainfall per year. That's why these areas have the arid climate with a little rainfall or rainy season. And generally, all that year rivers are become dry. During the rainy season, these different the river also getting some amount of water. Luni is the most important river which is found in desert region. Barkhans also very prominent. Crescent shaped dunes and longitudinal dunes are also found in Indo-Pakistan border. So up to this is the important characteristics or features of Great Indian Desert. And now the another part, this is the coastal region or coastal plain. This is the another topic by another division. This is the coastal plain. The coastal plain. In India, you know, in the southern portion, have a long coastline. They also have a Western Ghat mountain, last I have told, and Eastern Ghat mountain. In between Western Ghat and Arabian Sea, Eastern Ghat and Bay of Bengal, there have a coastal plain in India. India's coastal plain are also classified the two type. One is Western coastal plain and Eastern coastal plain. So Western coastal plain and Eastern coastal plain, it is most important feature of also one of the important feature in Indian physiographic division. So the peninsular plateau is flanked by stretch of narrow coastal strip. It is a narrow coastal strip. So running along the Arabian Sea on the west and Bay of Bengal on the east. A narrow coastal strip are also situated along the Arabian Sea in the west and Bay of Bengal in the east. The western coast sandwiched between Western Ghat and Arabian Sea. Very important question, what are the differences between Western coast and Eastern coast? So Western coast is sandwiched between Western Ghat and Arabian Sea, whereas Eastern coast is sandwiched between Eastern Ghat and Bay of Bengal. It is also important characteristics or features. It consists three section. Western Ghat also consists three section. The names are Konkan, Kannad and Malabar. So Western coast are divided Konkan, Kannad and Malabar. These are the three section or three division of Western coast or Western coastal plain. So the northern part of Western coast, it is called Konkan coast. It is also in between Mumbai to Goa. While the central stretch is called Kannad and the southern part of our Western coastal plain is called Malabar. These are the division of western coastal plain in India. So student, up to this you will read. Next day we will start eastern coastal plain and rest of this chapter. Thank you.